Democrats uneasy. Florida Republicans turning out at a higher percentage than Democrats in crucial Miami-Dade. It comes as a top Republican in that key state who helped lead his party in both chambers of Florida's legislature is supporting a Democrat for president for the first time.
I'm as Republican as it gets, a conservative Republican. But Donald Trump is an embarrassment to our party, to our country, and to the rest of the world. You see, I love my party, but I love my country more. My name is Mike Fasano, and in 2020, I'm a Biden Republican.
And Mike Fasano is out front with me now, former majority leader of the Florida House, president pro tempore of the Florida Senate, currently serving as Pasco County, Florida tax collector. And I appreciate your time, sir. So I'm going to ask you about this significant endorsement that you're making in a moment. But first, this news that we have, Florida's early vote ends this weekend. You've already surpassed 6.5 million people who voted early in 2016. Democrats do lead in the early vote, but Republicans obviously have narrowed that edge. And we keep hearing about Miami-Dade. The Republicans are turning out at much higher percentages than Democrats in Miami-Dade, that crucial county. When you look at that, what do you see? Do you see a big warning flag for Biden?
Well, I mean, regardless of a warning flag, it definitely should get the attention of any campaign when you see your opponent's numbers in a county where there's a lot more Democrats than there are Republicans. I would be certainly concerned that the Republicans are outpacing the Democrats in Miami-Dade. But this is not unusual. Miami-Dade has done this. I've been in Pasco County, Florida now for over 50 years. And it seems like Miami-Dade has a difficult time, especially the Democrats, in getting their votes out every election.
All right. So I think that context obviously is so crucial with your experience. Now, you know, you talk about, you know, 50 years and you have been a Republican all of that time.
Yes. Well, I've been a Republican since I turned 18. Yes, ma'am.
Right. So, you know, lifelong. And you told a local Florida paper, you know, as you've now have come out for Joe Biden, a Biden Republican, as you put it, quote, "It got to the point where I said to myself, I've got to speak up, especially as an elected Republican official. Not to say anything is a cop out. Shame on me for waiting too long." How hard was it for you to come to this decision and to speak out as someone who's been a registered Republican since you were 18?
Great question. I did not support Donald Trump 4 years ago. I didn't vote for Hillary Clinton. I actually skipped that race. First time in my life I skipped a presidential election and went right down to the remainder of the ballot. This year, I just couldn't stand by and stay idly by and not say anything. Absolutely shame on me for not saying something sooner. I should have announced my support for Biden and my disappointment in Donald Trump. You know, when Donald Trump got elected 4 years ago, many of us, especially Republicans, thought, you know what? Maybe he will bring this country together. Maybe he will change and cross over to the other side and bring people from the other side into the White House and work with them and do good for our country. But unfortunately, he hasn't done that. If anything, he's taken out of the White House decency and compassion, patriotism. And really what we have in the White House now is hatred. And we need to get rid of that.
So, you know, you say, again, as an elected Republican official, not to say anything is a cop-out, shame on me. I just want to be honest with you. Like, there are other elected officials in your party who clearly disagree with many things Trump does, and they don't like to talk about it, and they avoid it. They try everything they can to run the other direction from discussing it. And even now, at this moment, I don't know what they're going to do or who they're going to vote for. Some of them may vote for him, but some of them may not. But they're not doing what you're doing. Why do you think that is still the case?
I wish I had the answer for that, and I apologize not having that answer for you. I will tell you this, since I have come out over the last 24 hours, 48 hours, announcing my support for Joe Biden, I've heard from many Republicans, in fact, elected officials, who have thanked me for speaking out. I wish they would do the same. I can't speak on their behalf, but certainly I, for myself, I just felt it was important. I have a responsibility as a Republican elected official for many, many years, that I need to let those who have that have supported me over the years, that who I'm supporting for president and why I'm not supporting a Republican this time.
All right. Well, Mike, I appreciate your time. Thank you very much for sharing all of that with us.
God bless you. Have a nice evening. Thank you.
You too, sir. And now to some breaking